Hello everyone, welcome to Decode ITES. This is a single learning platform for multiple IT infrastructure technologies. Do like, share and subscribe our channel to never miss out our videos. Let's continue with the learning. Let's have a small introduction of myself. My name is Prince Garg. I'm having 3+ years of work experience and worked on NetApp, VMware, Windows, Google Cloud, PowerShell, Python, and Bash scripting. Kindly follow us on Facebook, Insta, LinkedIn, and reach out to us on ITESfun.com. So in this video, you will all learn how to install CentOS or Red Hat 8 using custom partitioning. You must have seen this screen on my previous videos. Under the system section, you can see installation destination. Let's go through it. Previously, we have selected automatic option from here. But now, as we are doing using custom one, you can choose custom partitioning option. Now, you have to click on done. And by clicking done, it will take you to the secondary interface. Under this interface, you can see it's showing 20 GB of space available and 20 GB of space in total. Now, this is because I have assigned 20 GB of storage to this machine, as you can see over here. See, we have assigned only 20 GB of space. Let's continue. It's showing new CentOS Linux 8 installation. From here, you can select what type of partition you want. Let's click on add a new mount point. Under the mount point, you have to select slash. Slash is basically root under which all your installation will perform. So under the root section, I will provide 18 GB of space. Let's click on add mount point. Clicking on the add mount point, you can see the mount point it is slash. Desired capacity is 18 GB. Device type is LVM. You have to change it to standard partitioning as you can't boot the system using LVM. Now the file system is XFS, which you should be using. Now you can see we are having 2 GB of space available and 20 GB of space in total. Let's create another mount point. Under the mount point, this time we select boot. Under boot, let's say we can provide 1 GB of space. On clicking add mount point, you can see it's mentioned for boot. Device type is standard. And file system is ext4, which is suggested for boot partition. Let's click on done. By clicking on done, you can see here is the two mount points available which we have just created. One is with XFS type and one is with ext4 type. By accepting the changes, it's showing that your customizations will result in the following changes to take effect after you return to the main menu and begin installation. It's also showing under actions that it will create a format for these two partitions. The mount point is root and boot. Let's accept changes. Now it's showing warning, checking storage configuration. Also, it's mentioned we won't touch your disk until you click begin installation. So let's click on begin installation. All set to install and the normal process will begin from here. Let's continue in the next video. Thanks for watching. Do like, share and comment our videos. Also subscribe to our channel.